In this segment, we'll talk about the definition of an inverse of a matrix. I'm not going to show you how to find the inverse of a matrix because that's in a separate segment. All we're going to do is to define what an inverse of a matrix is. So first, the inverse of a matrix is only defined for a square matrix. So let A be a square matrix. So let A be a square matrix, so which it is, because I'm telling you that, hey, it has n rows and n columns, same number of rows and same number of columns. So let A be a square matrix. Then if there is a B, which is also an n by n matrix, such that you find out that B times A, that you are when you multiply B and you multiply it by A matrix, and it turns out to be the INT matrix, then B is considered to be inverse of A. B is inverse of A. So that's all you have to do is in order to be able to figure out whether one matrix is inverse of another, and it's the definition of the inverse of a matrix. So let's suppose somebody gives you a square matrix, and then say that, hey, there is a matrix B, that when you multiply the B matrix by the A matrix which was given to you, and it turns out to be an INT matrix. Keep in mind again that the INT matrix also will be a square matrix, which will have diagonal elements to be 1 and the off diagonal elements to be 0. That's what an INT matrix is. And also be the same size as n by n, because all of these, this is n by n, this is n by n, so the resulting multiplication matrix will be also n by n. Then B is called the inverse of A. Now, keep in mind that this B matrix will not always exist for this A matrix. So that's why we say that then if there is a matrix. So always keep in mind that if somebody gives you a square matrix, it does not necessarily mean that the inverse of a matrix exists. And there are certain ways which you can prove or which you can identify to show that whether a particular matrix has an inverse or not. And those are the kind of things which we're not going into right now. But we wanted to be able to get through the definition of the inverse of a matrix. Now what happens is that if you get B, if you get the n by n matrix B to be multiplied by the A matrix and it turns out to be the INT matrix, then you also find out that A times B will also turn out to be the INT matrix. And this is one place where the multiplication of two matrices turns out to be commutative. So that will also turn out to be the same INT matrix. What this means is that if B is the inverse of A, then A is the inverse of B. That's all there is to it. Many times in some books, people say B times A is equal to the INT matrix is equal to A times B. In order to show that, hey, B is the inverse of A, that's not what you have to do. All you have to show is that B times A is the INT matrix, then this is automatically can be proven that A times B will be the INT matrix. Now, many times when the matrix inverse exists, then these two matrices are called to be invertible. They may call them invertible, that, hey, they can be inverted, that's where that word comes from, or people might say, hey, they are non-singular. So those are some of the other terms which are used for a matrix which can be, for which an inverse exists, that the matrix is invertible or the matrix is non-singular and so on and so forth. But here what we want to be able to do is we want to be able to see that what does it mean to have the inverse of a matrix. That's all we are trying to show here. So for example, if somebody gives you a matrix, so somebody says, hey, find if -5.5, 2.0, 1.5, -0.5 is inverse of 2, 8, 6, 22. So keep in mind that in this segment, I'm not showing you how to find the inverse of a matrix. That's shown in a separate segment. What I'm trying to give you as an example is that, hey, can you find out whether this matrix is inverse of this matrix? So what that means is that when I multiply this matrix by this matrix, that if I don't get the INT, if I get the INT matrix, then it is the inverse of the matrix. Otherwise, it's not. So all I have to do is to go ahead and multiply these two matrices, so I get -5.5, 2.0, 1.5, minus 0.5, then I have 2, 8, 6, and 22. So if you follow the rules of matrix multiplication, this is what you're going to get. So that's your homework. Matrix multiplication is shown in a separate segment. You get 1, 0, 0, 1. So you get this times this equal to the INT matrix. So that means that this is, in fact, the inverse of this matrix. And vice versa also, this is inverse of this matrix automatically. So if you take this matrix and multiply it by this matrix, you're also going to get 1, 0, 0, 1. So that means that if I take this 2, 8, 6, 22, and multiply it by the other matrix, which is minus 5.5, 2.0, minus 1.5, minus 0.5, you are going to get, again, the INT matrix 1, 0, 0, 1. So they are the inverse of each other. Now let's go and see that, how does it help us to be able to figure, how does this inverse of a matrix help us in solving simultaneous linear equations? So let's suppose somebody gives you a simultaneous linear equation and says, hey, go ahead and you have two simultaneous linear equations given to you, and you want to be able to find out what the value of the unknowns is. Let's suppose 2, 8, 6, 22. And somebody says, hey, you got two equations, two unknowns. X1 and X2 are the two unknowns, and your two equations are like this. How does matrix inverse help us to figure out what these values of X1 and X2 will be? Now, going back to our symbols, let's suppose, let's write it as a symbol. You got AX equal to C. So A is your this matrix, X is this, unknown, and C is the right-hand side. So in this case, what you can do is you can take the inverse of, you can multiply both sides by the inverse of the matrix, if that inverse exists. So keep in mind that this multiplication which I'm showing here is that this multiplication is allowed only if the inverse of A exists. So that's how I'm multiplying A inverse here and A inverse here. But A inverse times A is what? Is the INT matrix. So INT matrix times X is equal to A inverse times C. So I get X is equal to A inverse times C. Because when you multiply an INT matrix by any other vector, if the multiplication is allowed, then you get the matrix itself. So whenever you multiply an INT matrix by another matrix, and if the multiplication is allowed, then you get the second matrix itself. So what that means is that if I know the inverse of the A matrix, then I can just multiply it by my right-hand side, which is the C vector, which is this vector right here. Then I can find out what the solution is. So that's what I'm going to do. So what that means is that X1, X2 is equal to 2, 8, 6, 22, the inverse of that, times 46, 128. So that's how sometimes the inverse is shown, like A inverse, like this. That's how you should show the inverse of a matrix, A raised to the power minus 1. So that's what I'm doing here. I'm just moving this A matrix to the right-hand side by using the inverse of that. And now the inverse of this particular matrix, I already gave it to you in a previous in this particular segment. I gave it to you, and that was minus 5.5, 2.0, 1.5, and minus 0.5. And I'm going to multiply by the right-hand side, which is 46 and 128. And once I do that, I get, when I multiply this matrix by this matrix, I get 3 and 5. Again, the multiplication of the two matrices is covered in some other segment, and you can do this as a homework to look at whether the multiplication terms are to be 3, 5. So that's how you are able to, what the definition of the A inverse, of the inverse of a matrix is, and how you are able to use it to solve a set of equations. So that's the end of this segment.